This video starts on a white screen. The Microsoft logo appears. The screen fades to black. A green background featuring the letters A and I appears, followed by a slideshow showcasing new technologies.
AI for Accessibility is a Microsoft program committed to influencing the future of technology to empower people living with disabilities. Whether reimagining the future of accessible education, building experiences that are accessible for people of all abilities, or developing AI-powered technology to make the world more inclusive, we are pushing the limits of what AI can do.
Screen fades to black, a speaker appears.
Hi everybody, thank you for tuning in. We're in for another exciting conversation and we have a great team represented today from IStem. Shakul, thank you so much for joining us. I've been working with you for a long time and I'm very excited to be able to share with the public more about what you do. Can you please tell us more about your team and the type of work that you are doing at IStem?
Okay, first of all, thanks so much, Fiona, for providing us this opportunity. Really nice to be here. So talking about IStem, at IStem, our vision really is to provide information, resource, and opportunities to people with disabilities. And we do it by first developing technologies for people with disabilities. And second, we have some of our community initiatives that are going on side by side. So I'll start with our technology. So we basically are very much into content or document accessibility. So we started with developing a tool that could convert an inaccessible document for the screen reader into accessible format. And when I say inaccessible documents, I'm talking about documents that cannot be read by the screen reader. So people who are blind or visually impaired and some sort of people who are suffering with printed disabilities, they use something called a screen reader to access their computers or laptops in their day-to-day life. And there have been several digital documents that have not been accessible or compatible with screen readers. So what we really do is we convert these documents into accessible format using our AI-powered tool. But we understand that automated conversion cannot be 100% accurate. So last year, we started developing something called a remediation portal, where we develop another AI-powered tool with drop down options for several layout elements of a page that can help a remediator to fix the changes that AI might have left and really remediate the documents to achieve 100% accuracy. We recently launched our mobile phone for our individual users, where they can also convert their inaccessible document into accessible format. So that's in a nutshell about our technology. But we also work at the community front, where we have organized several hackathons, inclusive hackathons, where we incorporate people with and without disabilities. We organized several tech training program, mentorship program, where we connect people with suitable industry mentors or academic mentors. We ran a couple of recruitment initiatives for people with disabilities here in India. We are actively trying to engage more audience in the West, like, for example, US. I'm trying to work with several VR agencies in the US for our technical training program. So, yeah, this is in a nutshell what we do at IStem.
You mentioned that, part of it, AI is helping with the documents, but there's a lot that AI also leaves out. So what are some of the common common issues that you see that AI is currently not able to pick up, or what are the things where the manual remediation comes in?
Also, there are several things. Imagine what we do really do is do we start with an OCR. So what we do, suppose you've got a document and you want to convert it into accessible format, what we would really do is to convert it in image and take out all the text from that image for it to become a digital document. And after we retrieve all this text, we run our layout models into it. So for example, a table should be formed as a table, a heading should be formed as a heading, list, images, and so many other things. So what AI really makes mistake into sometimes, from the OCR aspect, sometimes it jumbles up a few sentences, there are character mistakes where you have to edit sometimes your text. But the major mistakes are in the layout. For example, your headings are not detected correctly. Either it has been detected as a paragraph or title heading could have been detected as a subheading and vice versa. Your table has not been formatted clearly. For example, imagine if you have a very complicated table like spanning rows or spanning column. If that has not coming out properly, for example, your list has not been formed semantically correct. And over here, semantical information are those which are a special and important attribute for a document to be accessible. So when we talk about semantical information, we talk about all these elements like list, paragraphs, headings, tables, two-column layout. And a two-column layout is another problem, right? Because what you really do is sometimes you have half of the text is written on the left side of the page and second half is written towards the right. Screen reader jumbles both the lines together, right? It basically reads the first half of the first line of the first column and then jumps to the first line of the second column. That really hampers the reading experience. So sometimes these so what we really do, we make this two column layout in one column layout and put the entire text of column two on top of column one. So these kind of small fixes that we need to change, taking out all the layout elements are marked properly, taking care of all the textual information. And the third is the reading order design, because we really want to define when screen reader is reading what, really, right? Suppose if you're on the page and at the top of the page, you have a, you know, graph of a QR, right? Where the QR code is given and then you followed by the chapter title and the chapter name and so on and so forth. It should have been read in a proper order so that it makes sense to people. So with our remediation tool, we provide them three steps. First, where they can select the layout information like list, tables, headings, and so on. Second, where they can edit the text and fix the textual mistake. And third step, where they can really fix the reading order issue. So if something is coming after something else, basically assigning the right orders to each of the elements of a page. That's what we really need to do with the remediation process.
It's very interesting what you're saying. And, you know, there's so many, obviously, documents and textbooks and books in general that have been built inaccessible or they're in a scan format that we have to make accessible. But I can't help but thinking that going forward, there is also an opportunity to start building things with accessibility in mind, and especially documents and books, because this is such a widespread issue in terms of if something is built inaccessible, we have to do the work to correct it, right? So it's a really great call out. So for the folks who might be tuning in, please make sure your documents are accessible. Now, I know that the team is also looking forward to advance your efforts in the next year. Can you share a little bit more about your plans and how you're thinking of taking this great technology forward?
So in the next year, we are trying to work on two major milestones. First is what we really want to scale our remediation process. So what has happened, what has been happening these days is that once we receive a document, our trained team of remediators work on them. And someone from the team who has significant experience with the screen readers goes on reviewing this document. This is a very operational heavy process and it consumes a lot of time of our internal team. What we really want to do is to crowdsource this entire process. For example, suppose you have a page. Can you really distribute this page with three or four people by, you know, creating subtasks to this page? And can these crowd workers be trained in like 15, 20 minutes on how to make accessible version of a document? So we are currently working on that, how to create. For that, we are starting with our user studies just to understand what are the, you know, things that we need to take care of in mind to really make it to a way where we can really scale this model up. The idea really is to involve so many people with least training and help them up to remediate this document so that we at IStem can, you know, give this work to several other people. And the good thing about this project is that, you know, you are in a way providing employment, like either part-time employment to several other people, but folks with other disability can also come into the picture. This is fun. We really want to scale up our remediation process and also want to give this access to our individual users also who are using our Android app right now. Second, since we are based out of India, we are planning to integrate our Indian languages into our remediation portal. So till now, we have been English focused, where one could remediate only documents with English, but now we are integrating other Devanagari languages like Hindi, Marathi, Gujarati, and many others whose script, another script called Devanagari in the back. So once that is integrated, we will have people editing all the possible documents that are written in these particular languages as well. So going forward for the next year, these are the two milestones that we'd be working on.
And for the folks who want to learn more about IStem or just be informed in terms of how this is evolving, what are some things or resources or website where they can find more information?
Sure. You can have a look at on our website, which is inclusivestem.org, inclusivestem.org. If you want to try out our portal, you can just type up on the Google URL portal, that is portal.istemai.com, portal.istemai.com, and you can try out our the services that I was talking about, the document accessibility services, the mentorship, networking, and all those things. Also, if you want to reach out to us, you can shoot us an email with your feedback at info@inclusivestem.org, info@inclusivestem.org. And last but not the least, you can also use our Android app. So if you are using an Android phone, in Google Play Store, you can just simply type up IStem Accessibility Solutions. And the first app that you would see over there, IStem accessibility solution developed by IStem teams, is the app that you can use to take care of your day-to-day document accessibility needs. And all of this document conversion is available for free of cost to our individual users.
Thank you so much for sharing with us today. I'm actually going to spend some time tonight on Android and researching your app and doing more and playing around with it. So you gave me nice homework. I hope folks who have been tuning in will do the same. And I'm really excited for the progress that the team will be making the next year and the next years, because this is such important work to drive accessibility. So thank you for tuning in today. And thank you for everybody who is watching this on demand. We hope you enjoy it. And let's preach the disability divide.